I couldn't succeed in business. And I really tried. I was married. I ended up having children. And I lost 9 jobs in my first 6 years after college. And I asked people to show me their hands, how many have lost 9 jobs in 6, and I only found one person, and he was a pastor.
And it's easy to understand.
Yeah. But I couldn't succeed, and after I lost my 5th job, my best friend was visiting me from Chicago. His name was Gary Smalley. He hadn't written any of his books yet, and I considered him very wise because he had gray hair. He was 8 years older than me. I was 26, and he was 34.
Wow.
And I said, Gary, I don't get it. I don't understand. I have a college degree. I understand my field, which was marketing. I'm not stupid. I have an okay IQ. And I'm not lazy. I'm first in, last out at every job I work at. But I just can't succeed. I can't hold a job for more than 6 months. And I don't know what to do. And Gary was wise. He said, let me pray about it. You know, so many times when we tell people a problem, they shoot from the hip. But Gary was wiser than that. And he said, let me pray about it. The next morning, he comes into our little tiny house. We had a 1,200 square foot house. And he said, how would you like to be wiser than all your bosses? And I said, yeah, right. And he said, no, there's something you can do. If you do it for 2 years, in 2 years, you'll be wiser than all your bosses. And in 5 years, you'll probably be a millionaire. And that was really ridiculous. I never made more than $13,000 in a year. I never made more than half of the average wage earner in America. But he got my curiosity going, so I said, okay, what do I do? He said, there's 31 chapters in Proverbs, 31 days in the month. Every day read the chapter of the day with pencil and paper in hand. Write down the wisdom and insights you gain and begin to use those in your work. And he said, do that for 2 years. It'll take you through Proverbs 24 times. And I promise you, everything will change. Well, I started doing that, and 18 months into it, in the next 18 months, I went through jobs 6, 7, and 8. But on job number 9, using the wisdom from Proverbs, I doubled the company's sales from $30 million to $60 million. And with that, I had an offer from a friend to back me in my own business. He had $5,000, and I had an idea. Well, using the wisdom I found in Proverbs, 5 months later, our tiny little company, our sales hit $1 million a week. Wow. And so Gary was wrong. I wasn't a millionaire in 5 years. I was a millionaire in 2.5.
Wow.
But I never chased money. I did what Proverbs says. Proverbs says if you chase after wealth, it'll take up wings like an eagle and fly off into the heavens. But he said, in all labor, there's profit. So you guys do your labor, and God blesses it. You haven't become wealthy, but you have fed tens of thousands, hundreds of thousands. You've put shoes on the feet of hundreds of thousands of kids. You've provided clean water all over the world. Mm-hmm. Why? In all labor. It's your labor, and it's motivated by love. And but I discovered that Proverbs, really, it answers every question any of us could ever have about anything, marriage, business. If you're an employee or an employer, it doesn't matter. Proverbs has the answer, and Solomon penned it. It was God's wisdom, but the only man ever to live Proverbs perfectly, of course, was the Lord Jesus Christ. Solomon couldn't even do it.